doesn't like that we get them cheap. So they must be setting the price and the tariff, surely. But you see, with the EU, you've got big people sitting at a big table. With the UK, then I'm afraid it's the canary down the mineshaft, isn't it? You know, that sort of idea at the moment. And we forgot that when we just came out of the EU. But coming out of the EU was not designed to benefit the UK. It was designed to benefit the Hooray Henrys, who are working the xenophobes from the back. Look on your social media and you'll say, my goodness me, that's Scottie McClue's well informed. One of the most powerful civil servants in the land. I had a conversation with them one evening at a big society do. And he went into his office the next day and he went, my God, that's Scottie McClue's well informed. I love it. Scottie, did you hear about the German doctor who came to London to speak about the coronavirus pandemic and got arrested for simply speaking at Hyde Park Speaker's Corner after the police rushed the... I didn't. No, I didn't hear about that. I was talking about the coronavirus. My goodness me. Very, very interesting. So why would anybody have concern about somebody talking about the coronavirus? I mean, it's not as if it's a secret, is it? Fantastic. Right. J-Dog, any more guesses about how many have seen our tweet, bearing in mind that it must have been up for 2-3 minutes now? Anybody fancy a go? Right. What number did you say, J-Dog? Tell me what number you said. Let me look back. So, Tony, 288. So, J-Dog thinks... after the police rushed them at Trafalgar Square, says God Saves. But surely at Speaker Corner, you can say what you like. Wonderful Betty McIver says 200. There you are. J-Dog, do you want to up your guess? Those aren't typos. I smell a conspiracy theorist, says Elliot Harris. Now, what do you mean by that, Elliot? Sorry. Who's not doing the typos? Or do you think? No, I don't. Tony, you're not a conspiracy theorist, are you? Yep, no bother. Cheerio. Polly, away. That's the question, Scotty. Why would they just for speaking about the pandemic? I don't know. It's very interesting, that. Very interesting indeed. Why would you just for having a chat about a pandemic? Why would anybody be bothered about that? Because, as I say, it's all over the place. It's not a secret. Coronavirus is not a secret. It scares me that when we leave the EU, we'll have to deal with America when we buy in our drugs and they will set the tariff. This will affect NHS budgets. I know Trump would want to remove the NHS. Yes, of course he would, because, I mean, that privatised could be making money. People need their health, but it goes completely against the whole British way of thinking, you know? And that's why people love the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, because it's got its own way of thinking. It's a very unique setup. Tony says, I'm not a conspiracy theorist. Don't worry. Good man, Anthony. So there we are. Right. Shall we fess up how many people have seen the tweet? Betty thinks 200. J-Dog thinks... Betty's saying 200 people. Betty, that's a good high spot. I can tell you that. If 200 had seen it... What have I done here? Something's happened. Oh! Where did you all go? So there we are. So Betty thinks 200. I'm going to announce it. Are we ready? Right to date, from our tweet of 3 or 4 minutes ago, which J-Dog retweeted, 601 people have seen it. How fantastic. 603 now. How fantastic is that?